my beautiful buddies, and welcome back to the channel for Working on the Safe File. And today we are going to be going on and doing Veronaville, and we're working on the Cap family home. So yeah, stay tuned for that. Right, Luca? Hey guys, welcome to the build. So I kind of want to do a little update for you guys before we start talking about the Cap family and Veronaville and like the backstory of them if you guys aren't familiar with The Sims 2. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start talking about like the save file, because I know like earlier in the quarantine and like this past year, like before like it really started getting pretty bad, I started working on the herbs for the save file. But I did a random poll on Twitter not too long ago, and a lot of you guys said that you wanted to see Veronaville first before you seen the herbs, and in particular you wanted to see it in Windenburg. So I thought, okay, I will go ahead and this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go ahead and do the next update as Veronaville, and then afterwards I'm gonna go back into it and then finish, I guess, you know, like the herbs, like SimCity, and do that in another update. So you'll still get the herbs, but you won't get them in the latest update. And I should be quicker because I do have some families. Like, I do have a family, well, not really a family, but they're like more of a group because it's kind of set up differently, I guess, than The Sims 2 is. And a couple builds, so that will be like quicker coming, I feel like, especially too since it's in the city. But yeah, that will be its own thing in its own time. I do have one more build for the herbs before I kind of just go full force with Veronaville for you guys, that I just thought, hey, why am I gonna save it until I'm done with Veronaville? Like, that's silly, like just show it kind of thing. So I will do like my next build or like upcoming one, one for like the herbs. But yeah, that save file, the version of that save file will be coming for a while. We're gonna be working on Veronaville. And that brings me, I guess, like to, I guess, the latest of like what I was like going to say about this, that this build took me so long. So if you guys really enjoy it, because this is on a 64 by 64 lot, and I usually don't do lots that are this large. I cut out a lot of footage for you guys, so I hope you guys really enjoy it. Get yourself a cup of tea or a cup of coffee and just sit down and relax, because it's quite a long one. And it took me on and off a couple of weeks actually to build this. And that kind of like brings me to my next point too, because I also feel like, I don't know if anyone else felt this way, but as much as I love The Sims, I just felt like Star Wars pack, that just wasn't it. And I've kind of felt like it kind of almost maybe like uninspired to play a little bit The Sims. So that's kind of like why I took a little bit of a break. Like, I was kind of like trying to capture, I guess, kind of my motivation, I feel like, to record again, just because it just kind of bored me. I just have to be straight honest with you. I didn't feel like that pack was, that wasn't it for me. I don't feel like, I'm gonna try not to add any of that in the save file, just because, I don't know, I just felt like, personally, if I wasn't a game changer, I don't foresee myself have ever bought that for myself, and I have to be really honest. And I have to admit, I feel like I was kind of scared at first to like say my honest opinions about these kinds of things, but seeing so many other game changers be so open about it and things like that, I just felt like it was okay not to sugarcoat it and be like, yeah, like I didn't like this, but you know, like it should be someone else's cup of tea. But it just feels like most of the community didn't really care for it that much. But yeah, we're moving on from that. So yeah, I got that some of my like mojo back, and we're back in the game. But yeah, it did take me a long time to do this one. And I kind of just like also wanted to say that I know that there's a lot of people doing save files now. Like, I know this is not like a revolutionary idea, but I have been working on the save file for quite a long time on and off. And like when I started it, there was only, I feel like, two popular Sim YouTubers, I guess, that had a save file. And there was people on Tumblr that also did it, but like there wasn't really anybody. Like, it wasn't a normalized thing. So I still feel like it's kind of special, kind of like my thing. But yeah, I have seen, I guess, ultimately more people that are doing the whole, bringing the old games into The Sims 4 kind of thing. And I don't know, at first I kind of like doubted my ability. I was like, oh no, people are not going to care for mine anymore, theirs is going to be so much better, people are praising them. But I was like, you know, no, that's silly, because I guess I kind of had like a moment of doubt. I feel like that also kind of like caused me to like not like record as much. And I was like, no, I was like, that's silly, people have been watching it, people do like it, and your save files, ultimately people like it because you do it with them, like on your channel. So I was like, you know what, I have to think more positive. So that's kind of just where my mind has been at. I feel like during quarantine it's just been kind of like really blah, and I feel like a lot of people have been kind of feeling that way. So I guess I felt like I wasn't alone, and I just like wanted to like, you know, take the time to really feel like recording, because I kind of hate it when people record and like you could tell that their heart and soul isn't in it. Like, I don't like doing that. And yeah, I ultimately felt like it was better. Oh, all said and done. But yeah, moving on with that said, I have been trying some new things with the channel, if you haven't noticed already. I have a new end slate, I have some new like social media panel thingies that are animated now. I have gotten rid of my animated intro, and some of you guys that are returning like subs may not like that, but I have gotten advice from a couple of YouTubers who said that they have also have felt that this way, that a lot of people would have voted, because that was another Twitter poll I had whether you guys want me to keep it or not, said that they liked it, but my analytics on YouTube say that you guys don't like it, like you guys click off of the videos like more quicker for that. So I decided just to make an executive decision and just decided just to start my videos like without the intro. So hopefully like that does some good. If not, maybe I'll bring it back, or like maybe I'll bring it back just for special videos, because I do have some other games I would like to play, like games that are not usually Sims kind of things. I have Tell Me Why, and I also have Ooblets like in my Steam folder, as well as Among Us, but I don't feel like Among Us is like really a YouTube video that you guys would want to see. I don't know, maybe you do, comment down below. that I feel like maybe I can add my animated intro back sometime, or just videos I'm really proud of. But yeah, I'm experimenting just without it, seeing if you guys like it more, seeing if I see an improvement in the watch time. So that's why I did that, in case you guys are wondering. Also too, I did bite the bullet and I did do a little bit of face cam in the beginning of the video, before I headed out, because I had one day where I was like, I had some extra time, I'm just gonna record something for you guys. So yeah, I am trying to do more face cam too, but it's baby steps, guys, baby steps, because I feel like ultimately I just have to get into it and just feel more like I want to, you know, like I feel like I want to feel more confident in my videos, I guess I should say, because I did take a little break after like a little while. But yeah, switching gears, ultimately let's talk about Veronaville and the Cap family, because not all of you guys played The Sims 2. But yeah, the Cap family is based off the Capulets from Romeo and Juliet. There was also going to be another family called the Monty family. I think it's just called the Monty family in The Sims 2, where they are based off the Montagues. And Romeo and Juliet is a play or a book, I guess you could say, from like the early times, from Shakespeare, early times. I am articulating so well today in this build. Oh, wow. And it's just basically a forbidden love story. It's really cute, but it's like in more modernish times. And Romeo and Juliet in this case are teenagers, and there's also some other families like inspired off of other, his other plays, like Midsummer Night's Dream. There's a Summer Dream family that you guys will see later on too. So that's basically what Veronaville is. It's based off Verona, Italy, which is where, like, you know, he inspired off of like, you know, Romeo and Juliet off of. So that's kind of what we're doing. And I don't blame you guys for picking Windenburg for this, because in The Sims 2, it had half a English style and then half of a Mediterranean style builds. So in this save file, I will have to convert, like, you know, like how half of it is like very, very modern builds in Windenburg. I will convert that to like more Mediterranean style looking buildings. Which brings me to my next point. If you guys have any suggestions for what kind of community like lots you guys want to see, let me know down below. And also too, we could also do, what I have been doing is that the sub neighborhoods for The Sims 2, like, I will pull the community lots from them, because I feel like ultimately they have had more interesting community lots. So that's what I've like done in the past. So if you guys have any like favorites from The Sims 2 community like lots, like, let me know, because I do feel like it makes it a little bit more interesting, because I know that there's currently like a couple of cafes and a library and nightclub there. I can't think of what else is there. I know the Von Haunt estate is there, that I feel like I will do like a renovation for too, like maybe I'll make it into a party area. So yeah, you guys just can let me know, because I feel like ultimately there's a lot of community lots, I feel like, in this world, and I just want to hear what you guys like want to see. And don't be shy to like name actual community lots from The Sims 2, because I have been feeling like I have been seeing a lot more people play older Sims games actually lately during quarantine, which is interesting, because I kind of feel like a lot of people, I feel like a lot of people just are kind of like missing some things from older games, because I do really feel like, as much as I love The Sims 4, that there is kind of like a sense of kind of emptiness sometimes when it comes to like gameplay. Like, I don't feel like it's maybe as fluid as older games have been, and I feel like maybe that's why a lot of people have, you know, been going back to it. I feel like in the upcoming year, I feel like I would like to see The Sims have like more rich game, The Sims 4 have more rich gameplay, because I feel like that's kind of like ultimately like what's missing, because I kind of feel like a lot of the packs, at least this past year, have been kind of felt like, okay, so you like do something and then you kind of like are done. Like, it's just, it kind of feels more of a something to check off your list kind of thing, rather than to build a storyline. So yeah, I don't know. Comment down below if you felt this way. But like with that said, I've loved The Sims. I've always loved The Sims. I feel like I could play it for hours and have fun. But yeah, I have been watching, who have I been watching a lot lately? Oh, Nixley. And I'm not really sure how she says her username, but I've been watching her Not So Berry challenge, and it just makes me want to do a Let's Play, but I know Let's Plays on my channel haven't done so well in the past, so like maybe I'll hold off on that. But I do feel like it has inspired me to do a current household, though, at least, because I do have a family that I have been playing off during like the time that I like took a little break, and I absolutely love them. So I feel like I could do like a current household. I don't know if those are still a thing, but like maybe I could do like little updates for the current household, like frequent ones, if I end up liking. So I don't know, I'm just spitballing, I guess. We will see. And yeah, that's basically all I've had. I have to like really update you guys about. I told you guys about the story, but yeah, let's keep on talking, because there is more tea. So we just got an update too for the game, for the skin tones, and word on the street is that they're still not fixed. Honestly, at the time that I'm doing this voiceover, I can honestly say that I haven't like popped into Creative Sim yet and seen them to judge them myself. But if that is, I hope they do really ultimately like properly fix that, because I do feel like, I don't know, I feel like that's something that we should have by now. And yeah, I just makes me think too, like, is the December update going to, like, the ones with all the sliders going to be delayed or not? Because I hope not, because I feel like people have been waiting so long for that. And ultimately too, I just feel like even though all the skin details and the makeup and stuff will break, I just feel like that's so much more helpful because there is so much makeup in The Sims 4 that just look that they it doesn't look good so bright unless you're like have like the middle skin tones, I notice. And I just feel like just having that opacity slider will be so much better. Also too, I also feel like I want this, but I don't feel like they'll give it to us, but I really want I just want more updated like hair color, because I just feel like the same 18 aren't enough. And I just feel like there's a lot of colors I kind of feel like they left out. Like I feel like, for instance, brown. Okay, there's only like 2 brown swatches, and I ultimately feel like the darkest brown, in my opinion, just kind of feels like a medium brown. Like I feel like they could have like a more darker, like ash brown, and they don't have that. And same with the black too. I feel like it's the blue black, they could have, you know, they could have like more of a true black as well. That mustard colored hair color, we're not even gonna talk about that ain't cute. But yeah, you see my point. And yeah, I just feel like that's something I feel like that we need to, but I don't know if we'll get that in the future update. Yeah, I don't know, I'm like not trying to be like so like blah, I guess, about the game. But like, yeah, I just feel like recently there's been like a lot of things that people have been like brought to attention that like they need to update and like they need to do. But yeah, also too, that as I'm doing this, I also added this gigantic graveyard in the back of this build, and I hope you guys like it because I feel like it's creepy. And I know that the original cat build did have one. I don't know how many graves they had in it, but I added quite a few just because I was like, you know what, why the heck not. And it almost kind of reminds me of the goth family, because I know, was it the goth family that had like a really creepy graveyard in The Sims 2, or which one? I don't know. One of the goth family homes in the past had like a really creepy graveyard, and it always gave me the freaking creeps as a kid. And it kind of like gave me those vibes again. Like looking back on it, I feel like it was really cool. But yeah, I felt like The Sims 2 compared to The Sims 4 was very, very like more, I don't know, like, I feel like it kind of pushed the boundaries for, like, the PG-13 rating, which is, I feel like in The Sims 4, it's played it kind of safe, honestly. But yeah. Also, too, I have, worked on a starter home that is in this world, like, it's in the the whatchamacallit, what word am I looking for? Vernaville. Sorry, I just hear people about like stomping around in my house, so I feel like it's getting me a little distracted. So that's why I've kind of like stopped here and there and like started to think. But yeah, I have done a starter home, which I don't think I'm gonna do its own video on, because I'm like debating whether or not I do all of my starter homes and just put them in one video, just like as a tour. Or I don't do, like, anything. I'll just, like, show some of them in the end, or just, like, leave them as a surprise. So I'm still kind of, like, debating on it. I do might make a post on, Tumblr or Twitter or both or something, just so you guys can still see it. But yeah, I did do, like, a cute little cottagey one, and oh my god, guys, I just loved the bug mode. I feel like I found so many amazing items in debug mode that before I feel like I didn't really use debug mode that much, but I feel like now I just finding so many cool like hanging plants that I feel like are so cool. They could have added those in the normal, like, you know, like build by catalog that they haven't. And also too, like, I just found so many just cool just items in general. Like, I feel like the fabricated eco lifestyle ones and then the craftables from the knitting stuff pack are such good furniture that I almost kind of wish that they just like put them normally in the catalog and just lock them instead of putting them in like debug mode personally. I felt like that would have been a better move, but that's just my opinion, to be organized, just because there is so many items to go through, and like the swatches are its own item and not like having like the, you know, like the little swatch category thing like pulling out, which I feel like would have been a better design choice. But maybe they'll be updated. We don't know. But yeah, you guys can let me know too what you guys have been up to. Let me know any saucy gameplay down below. And also too, whose save file have you guys been really enjoying besides mine, of course? I'm really excited for Delegacy's save file. She has one, I believe, of Newcrest, and I'm really excited to like take a look at it because I have always admired her as a creator, and I feel like she'll do a good job. I believe that she's been streaming it too, like streaming it on Twitch, making her creations. And yeah, I also too, whose other save file I felt like it was good. I also just like a bunch of them from Tumblr. I feel like Tumblr people don't get a lot of love because I feel like they have a lot of good builds, but a lot of them just don't do the whole YouTube thing, or streaming thing, so they'll get like push it aside a little bit. So yeah, don't doubt Tumblr. I feel like they have a lot of good creators, like even creators that like just do builds or do like create a sims and things like that, that just don't do custom content. So yeah, just like, and whenever you're feeling like some inspiration, that's a good place to go to besides like Pinterest for builds and just, I guess, just like interesting inspiration to make sims. That's another question too. Do you guys find create some inspiration too? Like, do you guys like find pictures of people or like models or something like that, and like base your sims off of it? Because that's something I never do. I kind of just kind of have an idea and just do it, but like builds I'm more likely to go ahead and just do one like sort of based off of a picture or something like that I like. But yeah, also too, I guess I can go back and talk a little bit about the family members from the Cap family. We do have, besides Juliet, we do have, do we have Hermia? I forget. Honestly, I kind of forget the other siblings' names, but I know we do have two other siblings. And one of them really, really hates, I feel like they all ultimately hate Romeo because of his family, but I do know that her sister, she's a little bit closer to, and her parents died. I'm not exactly sure how her parents died, honestly. I'm gonna do more research for, like, when I do the Create a Sim, which I will probably have a better backstory for them and that build. But yeah, basically just based off of Romeo and Juliet, this family, that's basically what you got to know. So the grandpa is very, very hard in stone. He's kind of like, this is the way it is kind of thing. And he honestly just would be so disappointed in her knowing that she's with him, because they just had this family feud for such a long time, for generations, and yeah, that's just the way it is. Also, ultimately too, because I know people are gonna ask and things like that, this is definitely not like to the T. Like, when I do my save file, I like to update the builds more to be just to be like, you know, current, like in the like 2020 kind of thing. So I don't really like to do them like exactly like how they were in like 2004 or whenever this game Sims 2 came out. But yeah, I hope you guys go ahead and enjoy this. Make sure you comment down below what community mods you guys would like to see, if you guys like this build, and I will see you guys soon. Okay, bye bye bye.
I don't wanna let you down. It's the only thing I think about every morning. You know my life ain't figured out, but I promise if you stick around it'll never get boring. We'll spend nights, cheap red wine, look at flats even though we can't afford them. I don't wanna let you down. I don't wanna lose you now. Will you stay? Even when you wanna walk away. When times get bad, we can learn to love what we have.
I don't wanna let you down.
in my life without you would be boring. And we'll spend nights, cheap red wine, look at flats even.